Namaste to all my renowned people, friends, and my dearest young readers. I'm back to spread fragrance and to blossom your day through the light of bliss and magic, quite known through fairy tales. Today's inspiring story is The Game of Truth. Once upon a time, there lived a young boy called Mamanana. He was the greatest warrior in the forest, and everyone spoke and sang praises about his bravery. One day, Freddy the monkey and Mamanana set out into the depths of forest to find the emerald, one of the finest gems. After a long walk, when the two sat down to take rest, suddenly they heard the sound of growling. It was a dragon. "A human in my territory," said dragon. "Run, brother." Saying that, Freddy ran and disappeared behind the trees. Mamanana sat there and dumbfounded. "Please don't hurt me." "Hurt you? Why would I do that?" said dragon. "And tell me, what are you doing in my territory? And why did the monkey call you brother?" "Oh, that's a long story," said Mamanana. "The monkey is my brother. One day, a sage came to my house asking for some food. When my brother was about to eat a red and juicy apple, the sage knocked the door. "Oh, my kind lad, I'm very hungry. Could you please give me something to eat?" said the sage. My brother lied that he did not have any food. Having smelled a juicy apple, the sage stepped inside and cursed him to be a monkey. Having heard all these stories, I rushed to the hermit, the sage, and begged him to reverse the spell. Since Mamanana was truthful and honest, the sage told him to locate the emerald in the forest. From then on, Mamanana and Freddy were walking to the depths of the forest. Suddenly, a bright light surrounded the dragon as it glowed with magic particles around it. "I am the emerald," said dragon. Mamanana sat on the dragon, and at once it flew away and came near a palace. "Why have we come here?" asked Mamanana. "To bring your brother back," replied the dragon. Then the dragon explained all about the pompous King Hama and his obsession to play the game of truth. "The king has captured all the fairies to whom the forest actually belonged. If you can somehow beat the king in his own game and free the fairies, they will help reverse the spell of your brother," said dragon. "Take this ruby horn to put it at stake for the game." When Mamanana was presented in front of the king was delighted to see the ruby horn. "All right, kid, remember the rule," said the king. "Rule 1, speak the truth no matter what. Rule 2, do not offend me no matter what. If I win, I will get the ruby horn. What do you want if you win?" Mamanana replied, "I want the fairies to be set free." The king was furious at this, but calmed himself down, thinking that there is no way Mom and Nana would win. Okay, let's begin the game. Place your palm on the spear and answer my questions. If you speak the truth, it will shine blue. If not, then red. Mom and Nana nodded. Question 1. Am I the most handsome man in the world? Asked the king. Mom and Nana whispered something and he finally said yes. The spear turned blue. The king hammer was pleasantly surprised. However, the ministers were shocked. Question 2. Okay, do you think I'm the kindest of all? Again, he whispered something but finally said yes. The king was completely impressed. Okay, the last question. Did you come here with a secret intention? Mom and Nana smiled and said, no. And presto, the spear shone blue again. Mom and Nana said this to the king. Your 3 questions are over, Majesty. Now it's my turn and I have just 1 question. Do you love your people? The king was startled. Never ever has it happened that someone got the chance to ask him the question in the game of truth. When the king said yes, the spear turned red, and so did the king's face in embarrassment. Hanging his face low, he ordered the gods to free the fairies of forest. When Mom and Nana came out with fairies, well done, Mom and Nana, exclaimed the dragon. Tell me, how did you manage to get the spear to glow blue in color when you were not telling the truth? Well, I have never lied, said Mom and Nana. For the first 2 questions, I whispered the truth under my breath, and about the last question, my intention was to free the fairies, and that I announced at the beginning of the game. The fairies were really pleased and impressed. When they reached the forest, the entire jungle rejoiced. The fairies turned Freddy back into human form and also announced that Mom and Nana would be the new king of the jungle. Through his wisdom and truthfulness, Mom and Nana became what he had always wanted to be. Moving to the moral of the story. There is no greatness where there is no truthfulness. Out of the mountain of despair, there is a stone of hope. It's the truth. So, stay true to yourself and to everyone around us. Catching you all with the next fairy tale.